Ladies and gentlemen,
yes.
Welcome to the Gary Payton After the Game Show.
That's me.
With your host, world-renowned, Hall of Famer, NBA champion,
yes,
Gary Payton.
Keep that music popping, don't you? Get it. Cut it off. Cut it. Hey, listen here, man. Y'all like my new introduction? Man, that's so sick.
What the hell has happened in 1 week?
Hey, Speedy.
Something happened with the fam, and listen, you didn't bought in a motherfucker from Jay Leno's show.
Listen, Speedy. This is a goddamn roll call right now, baby
What
boy.
The fuck?
Listen what I'm saying, man.
He need to say Speedy somewhere in there. Just say, Speedy. I don't give a fuck.
Man, fuck yo. Fuck that, nigga. This is Gary Payton's show, nigga. Fuck wrong with you. Nigga, ain't no Speedy in no. We ain't letting you introduce no more because you be, Speedy.
Yo, it's your boy Speedy.
Man, we ain't doing that shit no more, man. Listen, I'm about to do the roll call. I got my punk ass partner over there, Speedy. That's my partner. Then I got my man that knows everything, anything, whatever you want to know, whatever. He'll give him any kind of quiz. He gonna get down with you. What's happening, Jess?
You doing well, Gary? How you doing?
I'm doing okay. And then you know what I'm saying, my man that just did my introduction, who really, really I love. You know what I'm saying, Guy Black in the hit.
Right,
yeah. And then all
you know
of a sudden,
when you say you love, you gotta say no homo.
No, we don't have to say that because we're
not
cool
doing that boondock shit, man. I don't want all that shit, man. Shit. Listen, and then it's me. You know what I'm saying? That big dog. You know what I'm saying? Ruff, ruff, ruff. I ain't got to introduce myself no more because you know what's happening, man. Check this out. What's going on, man?
Hey, what's happening, GP?
Everybody okay?
What's that? Welcome to the show, XM98. Write the phone number down. It's 855-369-9898.
Here you go. You're taking over again. God damn it. I done told you.
I'm trying to help Ike.
I'm going to fire your ass in a minute, man. God damn. Eat the cake. Shit. Here you go. Check this out, man. What's our first topic, baby boy?
We got a great show for you. I have a question for you, though.
Yeah, talk.
We'll go football right now.
Okay, go football.
And I'm filling all the trades and everybody moving around, but I'm going to tell you right now, Philly look nice.
Ooh-wee.
Philly look nice.
Did you see him? Who did they just sign right now, Jess? They signed somebody good today.
Yeah, they got Nnamdi Asamoah, best cornerback in the game.
That was the other day.
They got Cullen Jenkins from the Packers. Vince Young as their new backup quarterback.
Vince was like, yo, we finna get rings.
Just got Brown today, right? Ronnie Brown from the Dolphins.
That's right. Last night they got Ronnie Brown. Running back.
Sean's coming back.
Deshaun Jackson holdout is over, so yeah, they're pretty set.
They're pretty solid.
Yeah.
All they got to do is just keep that quarterback situation. If Vic stay healthy, I think they're going to be
I don't think he'll play the whole season, but as long as he get – because that's one thing I love about the NFL is that you can go 7 games and win 7 in a row. If you don't win that back 7, ooh, that's your ass.
Well, when he got hurt last year, it really hurt him a lot. Yeah. It hurt him a lot. Yeah. But you got to understand, them Patriots over there, they're looking pretty good too.
Yeah, not like New York. New York,
who? The Jets?
Jets, man.
Man, they pretty strong, but I don't think they're going to get past
Philly. I like what the coach said. The coach said straight up, can somebody else beat New England? He put it out there. Somebody else got to beat New England. He said, we doing our part. We going to whoop their ass. Can somebody else whoop their ass?
Wait, he talking shit. Yeah, I like what you like about that, Jess?
I like the Jets better than the Patriots. They beat them in the playoffs last year.
Mm-hmm. Good game, too.
They've only gotten stronger. We'll see if Plaxico Burress can still play. But
he can. He's 6'5", 6'6".
He's a
just throw it.
He just went to the Jets?
Yeah.
Ooh, wee, I didn't see that.
Now what they're going to do with the other receiver?
They're probably going to let Braylon Edwards go because they signed –
Braylon's nice.
They signed Cromartie to the big deal, so sure that's did. Where they put sure all their did. Money in. Sure and, yeah, basically Plaxico's going to replace – going to replace Braylon Edwards, and they got Santonio Holmes on the other side.
Yeah, they signed Holmes, right?
He got nice money. 24 guaranteed, right?
Yeah, he got a lot.
See, that's what you 24. Do when that's what you do when you make a big catch, man, and when you're in the Super Bowl. Man,
who's your team? You Raider fan.
49ers, man. Don't get down like that.
Are you 40 in Oakland? 49 in San Francisco.
So what? That's the Bay.
But you live in Oakland.
It's the Bay Area, man.
But you live in Oakland.
Bay Area.
You wear the jersey and all that?
I wear everything, man. I do it. You know what I'm saying? I do it. What else, man? Listen, we've been talking about how these pro things and all that get down and how everybody needs to prepare mm-hmm. their kids and stuff to come to these to
yeah,
these
campuses. Because I was gonna ask you about that. My little nephew, 10 years old. He nice. He cool.
Yep.
So my little sister just spent like $500. He's in a little traveling team.
That ain't nothing.
Really? I'm thinking she's pushing him too soon. He's only 10.
No. When you want to push him, if you push him too late, he ain't gonna be ready.
So when do you suggest for parents? And we want you to call in too. If you have a son and you think he may have that potential, you can ask GB, when do you think you should start really getting behind him with the training, dribbling, and all that stuff?
I think they should start at the fifth grade, right? Like, not, even sooner than that. No, the fifth grade, fourth grade, preschool, and kindergarten, all that stuff. They should start playing basketball during that time. You know what I'm saying? Because then you get all your skills motivated and everything. It'll be all good. You know what I'm saying? And that's what
I think. When did you start pushing your son? I heard he nice.
Yeah, he pretty good. You know what? he pretty good. But you know what? He's a little cat, but my older son, my middle son, is going to prep school right now because he didn't pass SATs. I want to always stress these guys get out and do these SATs mm-hmm. and be knowledgeable. I done said this two weeks in a row. Mm-hmm. You got to get your schooling because these SATs are not basically for students. You know, not students like black us, students. Black students, really. So they got to get out there and learn that. You know what I'm saying? They thinking about this basketball as always.
24/7.
Yeah, but if you get hurt, you in trouble. You need something to back up. You got to have something up top. So he's going to prep school. He's 6'3". He's doing really well, dunking on people, doing everything. Everybody's looking at him right now. And I'm about to take him to school in 2 weeks, and he's playing. But the little one is pretty good. You know what I'm saying? And you got to push him now. But with my situation, as me being who I am mm-hmm. and being a legend.
GP Glove.
And it's not good for kids to live up to their fathers, like the Michael Jordans, the Magics, and us.
Dr. J, son?
Yeah, it's hard to live up to that. So
Kareem,
I don't push my son. Mm-hmm. I don't push him. I don't even deal with him. I get other people to deal with them because they be like, dang, man, you was the man. I can't do all that. These kids already own me.
So I should really be pushing the shit out of my son.
Yeah, you should. Because you sorry.
I should be in there like, get up!
Yeah. You should go home and get him
right now.
Oatmeal and shit and Cheerios.
No, I have a 6-year-old that he dreamed basketball. He loves Blake Griffin.
Uh huh.
He loved him. I took him to the game. Almost lost a little mind, but he dreams basketball. He's out there shooting his jumpers, and he shoot with the right. Mm-hmm. When he drives to the hole, he uses left.
That boy, that's ambidextric, so that's pretty good. Again. Ambidextric.
You want to spell that?
Ambidextric. I can't spell it, but I can see it.
You can't say it.
I can't say it.
I can't spell it either. Me we either. Are non-spelling.
We are non-spelling. But listen, because I'm ambidextric too. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm left-handed, mm-hmm. but I do everything with my right and left.
Now, do you teach? Is that something you also should teach your kids to do both, or just let it come natural?
No, I think it's got to be taught. Some people can't just have everything come natural. It's not going to happen. You got to make a person put his hand on. If he's already predominantly right-handed, you got to make him go left because people are going to start really looking at kids and be like, he can't go right. He mm-hmm. can't go left. He can't do this. And they'll start pushing him, and these kids will be nothing.
And I know we got to call. My son, or my nephew, played mm-hmm. against Bibby's team.
Right.
And Bibby's son was playing. He's kind of nice. Mike Bibby's son's nice.
Mike, he good. Yeah. He got a little cockiness to him, but he's going to be
that's
good.
That's good for
he's
going
to
like
be
that.
As good for that. But you know what? That's good for every kid. I like anybody cocky. But, we got to go. We want everybody to call in, man.
Call in.
You know what? 855-369-9898. And listen.
What's that?
Call us in, man. Let us know what y'all parents think about in. Your parents. Yeah. Call in. Yeah. But we got to take a quick break right now. We'll be out in a hot second.
Okay, before we take the break, we want to go and send out prayers and shouts out to the family of Bubba Smith. He died today, 66 years old.
Bubba Smith, did he?
Bubba Smith died in Baldwin Hills today, Baldwin Hills, California.
What's wrong with him?
They don't know the cause of death. They found him in his house.
Okay, much love to their whole family.
Gary Payton, after the game, we'll be back.
Speedy. Hey. There we go.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
After the game.
Get it.
Live.
I can dunk.
Woo! No, you can't.
Live.
I can dunk.
No, you can't.
Yes,
hey, no, you can't. Woo. Hey, y'all live. See? Hey, listen. Y'all see how I came in here? I had to change the groove a little
bit.
I changed it a little bit, right?
Yes, you did.
And then if you guys don't know who that is.
Who that is?
Who that is?
Who that is?
Who that is?
Who that
but
is?
Y'all just don't know. But now I'm going to tell you. It's a special guest.
Special guest.
That I done came up in here with.
You? If y'all I thought know I made that, the call.
You who?
I didn't make the call?
Man, shut up.
Okay.
So listen. You know, if all I think all you older people know who this is, who this is. The younger people, the younger generation, yeah, really don't know
is that
what's
Puffy?
Going on. No, it ain't no Puffy, man. We came with another man. That's Jonathan Butler. Yeah. Yes, sir.
BJ.
And listen, I got him right here, right now.
Right here, right now.
Welcome,
man. I'm excited to be here with you guys, man. I listened to you guys in my car, you know, and I crack up. By myself.
We apologize for the language. My bad. We apologize.
No, I'm praying while I'm laughing. Okay. I'm praying while I'm laughing. I say, Father God, bless these guys.
And if people you don't know, Jonathan is a preacher, so yes. That's why he's praying while we cussing. You know what I'm saying?
As
and
you I know, hope, we haven't cussed.
And we haven't right
we
now.
Haven't
and right we're now. Not going to cuss right
no,
now.
No, we're not.
But Jonathan,
soon as he go out there, though.
Please pray for us, too, while we cussing.
Man, you know what I'm saying? Show, man.
It's a good cuss.
I enjoy the show. Really, I do.
Thank you. And who do you have right here to your left?
Yes.
You know, this is my youngest daughter, Jody Butler. She travels with me.
Jody.
She's been
What's
singing
up,
with
12.
Guys?
She looked 12.
Yeah.
She's
12.
No, not yet.
Yeah. Oh, not yet? Okay.
I'm just kidding.
She's been singing with me since she was 15. And, you know, now we travel the world together. We've
That's
been
beautiful.
To Africa together. We've been... I don't know every that part of the
beautiful.
World. We just, you know, I take
and
it with
it's
me.
It's so weird.
Hold on, Jonathan.
Yeah.
Shut up, man.
I know. Yeah.
Let Jonathan them talk, yeah. man.
My bad. It was so weird because we were talking about pushing kids, you
yeah.
know, in basketball. When did you know your daughter had it, and when did you really start to push her?
Well, you know, I knew that she had the potential. You know, she had the gift, and I think it was just about mentoring her and releasing her. Once I started feeling comfortable and confident, and she felt confident,
mm-hmm.
then I felt, you know, God said, just release her. And mm-hmm. by releasing her, she's just doing the thing, and I'm
beautiful.
Really excited to have her with me.
Well, yeah. let's hear from your daughter. Well, when did you feel comfortable?
Yeah.
When I started paying her.
Daddy, the check didn't cash. It didn't clear. I love you, Daddy.
Let her say something.
Amen. Well, I started in church, and so then I sang a solo, and he saw me. And then from then on out, we've just been kind of...
Yeah.
That's beautiful. Man.
You know, yeah. together with everything, we've been traveling since for so long now. So
she
now
doesn't
it's
want to
just
be in economy. She doesn't want to sit in economy class.
You know,
it's a problem.
Oh, she's in first class.
If I could sit in business, then, you know, bless.
You know. Yeah. Business is just like almost first class. It
you
doesn't
know?
Matter. It doesn't
I
matter.
Wouldn't
it
know.
Doesn't matter.
I wouldn't know.
No, you in the baggage claim.
Yeah. Yeah, I travel with Jamie, and I have to walk right past him. I'm like, you don't want to hook me up with the seat?
Well, Jonathan, tell us
yeah.
what's going on and you know, what's going on in your life now and with you and your daughter, y'all traveling. Let all the world know what's really going on.
Well, first of all, you know, we've been in the States for I'm married for 29 years, so
beautiful.
Congratulations.
Clap for that. 29.
Beautiful.
Thank
God.
Thank God.
Person.
Yeah, thank God.
Thank
I
God
can't do
that.
29 days.
And I've been doing a lot of recordings. I mean, about 15, 16 records and touring a lot.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, doing mm-hmm. a lot of touring. But the last, you know, for the last 10 years, I felt there was a shift in what God wanted me to do,
mm-hmm.
which is more ministry-based. I started, you know, really concentrating on ministry and
wow.
not just entertainment.
Yeah. Right.
Because every time I do a concert, people come to not just hear Lies or Sarah, but they want to hear, you know, falling in love with Jesus.
Yes.
Falling in love with Jesus. And then, you know, I can't leave it. I can't leave the room without singing that. And I
right.
just started, you know, accepting this as my ministry.
And your nationality
is South African.
South Africa.
Yeah, from Cape Town, South Africa.
Okay.
She was born in London. Her sister and brother was born in South Africa. Yeah.
But you sound, is it more like, you sound more like your dad.
Yeah. I mean, he still has an accent. My mom's is really strong.
Really,
so,
okay.
you know, it's kind of a mixture between all three
yeah.
of them.
Yeah. All three of them.
Yeah. Well, there you go.
But I like it. I like it.
Thank you.
I like it.
Jonathan, the whole band makes
yeah,
fun.
Jonathan,
of
we got a we got your new CD here.
The new
what motivated you to do this so strong?
Man, you know what? I've been through a lot. You know, my wife is a cancer survivor. My brother Wayman Tisdale, who I became very
yes.
good friends with,
mm-hmm.
who
yes.
suffered with cancer, died. My mother
mm-hmm.
died,
mm-hmm.
and I had to figure out. I was signed to a new record label, Mac Avenue, mm-hmm. and I had to come up with a record. And I, you know, a buddy of mine, Kurt Likes, wrote a lot of songs with me, and I wanted the record to be fun. So Strong, it's basically saying, you know, I'm still standing, and we're still standing in the midst of all the things that's happened.
You know what I mean? And you know what, Jonathan? My mother is a surviving breast cancer person, yeah. you know, and that's really great. And we want you to sing So mm-hmm. Strong. We was going to really basically play it.
Yeah.
But since you're here,
and you have
got
guitar.
So much joy. You got so much joy into
but
you.
So Strong has got a whole nother vibe to it, you know what I mean?
Okay, let's hear it.
You wanna try it?
Sure.
Uh oh.
Hey. Uh-huh. Am I there? I said to him. So strong. So strong, your love is so strong. Baby, so strong, your love is so strong. So strong, your love is so strong. Baby, so strong. Tell me this, like to know if there's someone else. Did you come with your girls? Are you by yourself? If you like to be friends, I'd like to take you out. Maybe then we can see what this is all about.
So strong,
so strong,
so strong.
Your love is so
strong. Baby, so strong.
Your love is so strong.
Oh, so strong.
Your groove is so strong. Baby, so strong.
Yes, sir.
So strong.
That's what I'm talking about.
After the
what is wrong with you,
I
man?
I like the song.
Hey, listen, I didn't talk to management already, guy. We're gonna have a replacement program in here for him, man. Well, he's just doing too much.
That's why Jonathan
I'm so strong.
Is here.
You so strong.
I'm so strong right now.
And Jonathan,
yeah,
I got a little gig for you on Wednesday nights if you want to come on in here, man. We can replace this cat right here, man.
Where's
I
the lose. Gig?
Yeah, but here it is, right here, man.
Right here,
I get you. I give you anything you want to, man. Anything you want, I give it to you.
Give me some, let me see.
What you need?
What can I have? Some, a little cabinet?
Okay, that's what I'm talking about. I got that. I build it. Whatever you want. Yeah, I build
now,
whatever.
When you first dropped, would you say you were jazz?
I was
more, I thought
jazz. It's more R&B. When I started out, it was R&B music. And then I kind of, you know, departed from, because at the time, it was cool. And then, you know, lyrically, things just started weird.
Okay.
And I just said, you know, I need to maybe just stop for a minute and concentrate on what's happening in South Africa. Because back then, there was a lot of riots and the uprising was intense in South Africa. Mm-hmm. And when, you know, our president Nelson Mandela came out of prison, I just decided to write. So I wanted to write about my country and what we were going through. And I think it's important to tell those stories. You know,
beautiful, man.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Good.
So you got to do Sarah. I don't know when you want to do it.
I'm ready.
Song.
If you guys are ready.
I can clean the whole house.
You going to sing live?
Yeah. Well, what we're going to do is, Jonathan, we're going to first, we're going to take some calls. I want people to call in and ask you questions and do little things like that. And then we're going to go into a break. But then as soon as you come back, because you're staying with me. You're
going
to stay with me.
I'm here.
You know, you got to stay
with
me.
I'm in the Fox
you
know what I'm saying? You family.
It's the Fox
home.
There you go. But we're going to take a couple of callers.
Yeah, call
Please
in.
Call in and ask Jonathan anything, his daughter. You know, don't ask Speedy nothing. We don't want to talk to him today.
855-369-9898.
Here he goes. See, you're always over-talking me, man. I done told you. You're Robin. I'm Batman.
Sometimes Robin said some things.
No, he did not.
Yes, he did. He said, Holy Toledo Batman.
Oh, and then he said, bam, bow, boom. And then I always had to come over. Get you out of
Well, let me get my Batman bow, boom in.
Well, get it.
All right. 855-369-9898. Bam, bow, boom.
Okay, listen. Now, since you done messed up my whole vibe, Jonathan, I want you to play right now.
Okay.
I want you to do your thing. You do what you got to do.
Saw him across a crowded room. She looked so good. Memories came rushing into my head. There was a sparkle in her eyes. Was it for me or my imagination running wild. Oh, oh no. I see the more things change, the more they stay the same. Thought I was past the pain, one thought of you, and it's back again. Sarah, Sarah, what happened to you and I? Sarah, 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 how did the fire die? Whoa, Sarah, Sarah, what happened to you and I, baby, baby? Sarah, 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 how did your love die?
Hey, check it out. Ghost Team.
Who is it?
Do what you gotta do.
Yo, it's After the Game with Gary Payton
and Speedy
on Foxhole 98, baby. Make sure you got the number written down. Write down the number. It's 855-369-9898.
Listen, why I do that always, for my... why you always gotta say and Speedy? This is not your
Robin
show.
Robin says something, man.
Robin doesn't say nothing. Did you see the 19? Hold on. Let me show you what you were supposed to do. I told you I'm going to replace you in a minute,
okay,
right?
Let's just try.
Watch this. All right, we're going to start it over. Put the music back up.
Quentin in New York. Put the music.
Okay, there you go.
Ready?
Hey, wait, hold on. Beat it a little bit because we got to get a little groove on. Yeah, there you go. Hey, there you go.
Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back.
Uh-huh.
To the All Famous.
Uh-huh.
All new.
What?
Number one.
Uh-huh.
Show in the country.
Uh-huh.
It's the Gary Payton After the Game Show. Woo!
Hold on. Now cut the music.
Now let's try my. Hold on. Let's do it my way.
Okay.
Play the music again. Now watch me. Let it feel.
I gotta let it feel. Uh-huh. Here we go.
Okay. Give me the cue.
Do it.
Yo, welcome to the show. It's After the Game with Gary Payton and Speedy. Write the number down: 855-369-9898. That's real smooth right there, my brother. See, ain't no blackface on.
He just don't learn.
See, I ain't.
You see, why did we?
That was
even
real
do
sexy.
That?
I was sexy right there.
Excuse me. How you doing, Jonathan?
Man, I'm having a ball with Speedy and everything.
Thank you. See how you remember that?
Well, Jonathan, we're gonna go to your daughter now.
Right.
Yeah, we gotta go to her.
Uh-oh.
We gotta put her on the spot.
Right.
Concise. And you know what? You have a lovely daughter.
Man, thank you.
Very lovely daughter.
You notice I'm not really looking at her. I'm focused on the white man right here. I know he's getting blushing because I keep staring at him, but I can't really look over there.
What is wrong with you?
I'm single. I just got to stay focused.
It doesn't matter. Not right now. You single-minded.
I looked the other way.
What's wrong with you, Kat?
I have 8 kids. I looked the other way.
You got 20 kids. See, that's why he really said you single-minded. You know what I'm saying? That's really why you single-minded. Well, let's stop focusing
on Speedy.
Oh, my goodness.
And what are you doing now? Let's know what's going on.
Well, I am his background singer, so I'm touring with him. Right. We've got 2 tours going on and currently working on my own album.
Oh, is that right?
Solo.
Yeah, solo.
So listen.
My first
go
album.
Ahead. I'm sorry.
Oh, no, I'm good.
It's your first album?
Yeah.
And it's going to be a great one. I know it is.
Oh, yeah. It's hot.
Do you write?
I write. And I have my producer and we collab.
Okay, so right now, could you just blow me a little something right
now?
Oh,
Lord.
Yeah, I'm putting you on the spot. I just want a little something. You know, your father's going to do with the guitar. And let me see.
Oh.
What's that thing?
Hey.
Okay. I'm too far gone.
Uh-huh.
Our love is lost.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
You can feel my touch. You left there all alone.
Uh-huh.
Now you're left. Uh-huh. to pick up the pieces. I'm stronger now. And now that you are gone.
There you
come
go.
On. That's what I'm talking about.
Too far gone.
I hey, got listen. To go get my kids up.
Hey, listen.
Make them do some things.
Your kids?
Shit. All that zoo, you don't want to do that, dude. You know. Listen. Here on the Gary
Payton
Show,
good, right?
It sounds great. Sounds and you good. Sound
Thank
great.
You.
And that's what I was just about to say. Here on this Gary Payton Show, Speed we up. Will support anything, any CD that you have.
Aww.
You know, anything. You
Thank
know, anytime you want to get it out there, we'll do whatever it can. You want to come on here, do whatever you want to do, promote it, whatever. This is what we're here for. You know, it's
we'll be on Wednesday. We'll be on Wednesday.
Yeah. Okay.
Hey. With the full CD.
There it is.
Hey, I have a question. Being on tour with your dad, did you the first time you went, did you get nervous or were you?
You know, when we were growing up, my sister actually, she's a singer as well, but mm-hmm. she was the singer mm-hmm. and she wasn't scared. And I was completely frightened.
Wow.
And then when I started singing in church and I was the praise and worship leader for both the youth and the big church, mm-hmm. that's when my confidence really went up. Okay. So, you know, now it's just, you know, been doing it for so long that it's kind of like
it's natural, yeah.
It's like it comes home, it's second yeah.
Nature. Yeah, yeah. I'm a comedian, so I've been doing
okay.
it.
Any second his second as he can't even comedian right now. He's not funny. He
can't comedian.
Comedian.
Yeah, I told y'all comedian.
Wait, what did I tell y'all? That. Hold on.
Yeah, that's what I do. Hold that's on. Gonna be my new word.
Hold on, Jess.
Can't comedian.
What is that called?
Do comedy?
No, when I say comedian.
Oh, that's the Who's? Gary Payton word.
There it is. Oh. That's a Gary Payton word.
The GP word.
That's my dictionary, you guys. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So I have that. So let us know. Let the fans and stuff out here know about your Twitter, your Facebook, whatever you got.
I'm on Facebook. I'm on Twitter. Mm-hmm. I also have the Jonathan Butler website.
What's your Twitter and what's your Facebook?
Man, the Twitter I'm not really too hip with. But Facebook.
He's on Facebook
and,
all day.
I'm on Facebook all the
That's
time.
Me, yeah.
And, you know, I have currently, I've just produced my very first branded tour called Soul of the Summer with Eric Darius and Mesa and we out on the road, and I would really love people to come out to see us. I'm also currently touring on my own through Africa and then I'm hosting for the very first time. I'm really proud to be hosting my very first safari to South Africa. Wow. So all the fans, you know, they're listening out on the radio today. They can just go to Jonathan Butler.
When is that?
This is November 5th.
Okay, can we come and broadcast that?
Huh?
I think we come.
Can come and broadcast that?
Y'all can come anytime.
All right.
That's what we want to talk to. Yeah, we gonna do it.
Hold on.
We're doing this.
Get the tourism board.
We're doing this.
And it's a cool thing, everybody. They can go to my website, jonathanbutler.com, and check out. And also, you know, we have South African Airways supporting us as well. This is really a cool thing for friends from America to come out to South Africa and see it
through
my
eyes
and show them what it is.
Okay. Speedy can't go.
I can't go.
South Africa. A little passport problem.
Oh, you got a child support?
Hey. Watch your mouth now.
Child support. You can't get a child support? Boy, you something else, boy. What is wrong? The government done got you on band? Woo!
Any brother out there that should know that if you owe $2,500 or more, you can't travel abroad.
No, he don't owe $2,500 with nine kids. He owe like $48,000. You know what I'm saying? You can't get a passport?
I have a passport, stupid.
Where is it at?
San Diego.
You got jokes now.
I'm just trying to passport to San Diego. I'm just trying to figure this out.
John, they got jokes now.
See, I've been listening to your show, man, all the time.
Thank you, man.
You guys, I'm playing also on this weekend. We're playing Friday night.
Hyatt Regency, Newport Beach.
We're doing the gig there.
Oh, we'll be there. We'll be there. I'm coming. I'm coming.
And we got Detroit next week.
We're all over the place. Mm-hmm. All over the place.
Good. Speedy can't come to all them places.
I'm good.
Newport, you can't.
I can do Newport.
You can't.
Yeah.
Too many. We're serious about trying to do the show over there because our boss right now, Jamie Foxx, is actually in South Africa.
Are you serious?
Yeah, he just left today going. Yeah.
Is he playing there or is he just hanging out?
He's doing business there, TV film business.
That'll be amazing. That'll be amazing.
So it'll be nice to do that.
This is our first
Gary Payton
this,
show.
This is our very first inaugural safari that we're doing. But of course, we're looking to do more next, you know, year after year after year, you know, as well as the tour, Soul of Summer.
Who's on there?
Soul of Summer is Mesa and Eric Darius, and we pay tribute to Curtis Mayfield. We pay tribute to Angela Bofield, Donnie Hathaway. Ooh. We kind of sort of retell the stories about great American classic R&B music.
Yeah, you should invite Layla.
I'd love to. She's one of my favorites. I mean, definitely one of my favorites.
Absolutely. Jonathan, I've never
done
been
as soon as you get
there. That's the only country I've never been is South Africa, and I want to go with your passport.
Well, let me tell you, you know,
it goes everywhere else.
Oh, okay.
No, you're gonna have fun if you go to when you get to South Africa. You're gonna be like, wow, this is it.
Is it hot? Is it really hot?
It's perfect.
They said it's 50 degrees right now. There.
It's actually the coldest winter they've had.
It's cold right now.
Yeah. Oh, it's winter now.
It's winter. Yeah. We just
Our
came back from Angola.
Is their winter.
Okay.
We just came back from Luanda like 2 days ago.
Wow.
And that was kind of, you know, interesting weather to warm weather. Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. I got to get out a little bit more. This is ridiculous. The number to call into if you want to speak to Jonathan Butler is 855-369-9898. And you can get the album. It's out right now. It's called So Strong. And I love that title.
Thank you, buddy. Thank you.
How did you come up with that title,
So Strong? Well, man, I felt strong.
Yeah.
I was strong.
And your voice got a lot of strongness into it.
Strongness. Absolutely.
Strongness. Y'all got to get my words, man. Y'all got to get my words. It's
GP
not
words.
Strong.
We have a dictionary. It's coming out.
I need to write
it's
that
a dictionary
down.
Strongness up in that word.
You like that, huh?
I need to write that
yes,
down.
Yes, strongness.
Oh, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Loving it.
It's like five T's in that.
Oh, strongness.
Strongness.
You know Listen, we're going to take some callers, right? Yeah. We got Dwayne from Pennsylvania. Come on, Dwayne.
Hey, good evening, everybody. How y'all doing tonight?
What's happening?
Good. Hey, Jonathan Butler.
Yes.
Great music. I love your collaboration with Juanita Bynum. Man, can you do some other collaboration with like Andrea Bocelli or maybe Celine Dion?
Wow.
Ooh,
that's
big
that's
money
deep.
Right there. That's,
wow.
That's big money.
Big money right there.
My heart has just stopped going on. My heart will go on, but it just stopped. No, I would love to collaborate with a lot of people, you know, but you never know. I mean, you can never tell. I mean, these days, it's, I don't know, you know.
Because on those collaborations, is it you calling them or maybe they're giving you a call?
Well, it's labels. A lot has to do with producers and labels trying to make them put that marriage together, you know. So, you know, if it's the right situation, you know, like with Nita Bynum, that was the perfect situation. Mm-hmm. And it worked really well. Yeah. Thank you, though.
Thank you for the phone call, man.
Well, thank you for the phone call, man. You did it. We gonna go a lot of callers now. Yeah. What you think?
Let's squeeze that in.
You need a hair. You need a shave.
I will now.
Yeah. We got Clyde from St. Louis.
I'm going with the Rick Ross look.
Clyde from St. Louis. Come on, talk to me, Clyde.
Hey, how you doing, GP?
How you doing, buddy?
All right. I'm a big kind of fan of you when you played. When I was a Bulls fan, and Michael Jordan put it to your ass.
He said Michael put it to you.
First of all, Michael ain't put shit through my ass. Excuse me, Jonathan.
Sorry about that, Jonathan.
But God bless him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord. Bless me. Keep saying it, Jonathan. Because Clyde, you done fucked up now. You know what I'm saying?
Bless him, Lord.
He the only motherfucker he was scared of me. So you done pissed
bless
me
bless him, Lord.
You
know and he's pissed off right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, it is, you son of a beep, beep, beep. And all that, all right? You hear me, Clyde? You ever say that again? Get your ass off the phone. Go on, next.
Yeah, take that little thing out your throat.
Bless God for these the guys. Throat. Oh, man.
Hey, Gary Payne.
Can we just get a quick prayer? Yeah, don't be that.
Jonathan, I'm sorry.
No, you go.
I flash.
Yeah, you go.
I flash. He gonna call me. He gonna call my show talking about he put something in my ass.
What's the wrong with him? What's the most he ever hit you for?
Ask not what you can do for your country.
What's the most he ever hit you for?
He hit me for like 37.
And what'd you give him?
I was a rookie.
You was a rookie. Okay.
I was a rookie. I didn't even really score no points.
Okay.
But then when I started becoming
GP Glove.
Oh, okay.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, it was always a busting the bust of the ass.
What's the most you hit him for? What's the most you got him for?
Oh, 36.
You hit him with 36?
Huh? Excuse me.
36?
What's my name?
GP Glove.
God dang it. Well, Jonathan, I want to ask you something. Are you a sports fan?
I'm South Africa, you know, we grew up with soccer. Now I love basketball.
Football.
And I love football.
Football.
Football. My son, football. Her brother is now with the Saints. He's
He's a linebacker, and he's out there trying to get his thing together.
What's his name?
Shout out. His name is Ezra Butler, and he's
he's nice.
Ezra Butler, and he's out there with the Saints right now. We sang a little prayer for my son so he can get his thing together.
Okay. And who is your favorite athlete right now? Who do you like watching?
Who do we like to watch? Let's just collaborate together.
One.
We watch the Lakers. You know, we watch the Lakers.
Like, but I want to know who is your favorite athlete? Both of you guys.
Kobe.
She loves Kobe.
Kobe.
Who you like?
Well, you know, I must say I love Kobe too. I also like a lot of different cats from the East Coast, but I don't know their names as well as she does.
Okay, so in my era, who would you like in my era?
You.
Thank you. And who would you like?
I'm glad you got that note.
You,
yeah.
Yeah. I'm so passionate.
I gotta get it out there right now.
I slid it right past. I said, "Go on and say that, please."
Get it out there right now. Hey, Jonathan, I'm gonna try something new.
Yeah.
I want you to introduce the callers now.
Yeah.
And it's like your show. If this was your show right now, what would you do right now? And here goes the caller. So you do whatever you want to do with the caller and everything. Go ahead. Just go introduce the caller.
What's up, Royce, California? This is JB. Talk to me. I guess you want to talk to me.
Or talk football.
Come on, Royce.
Hey, what's
Royce.
How you doing, everybody? Good job. Nice sound, Jonathan, and your daughter there.
Thank you.
But I had a statement and a quick question. For the parents that are working with their kids.
Yeah.
You know, work with your kids and support your kids.
Yeah.
And allow your kids to develop and follow their own path.
Yeah.
You know. If you played sports before, it's nice and all that you can, you know, can relate to the kids, but
right.
Allow them to follow their own path.
Exactly.
You know?
Exactly.
And then, GP, I got a question for you. When you were going towards the end of your career, how did you deal with coming to the reality that you were going to hang it up and try something new?
Well, you have to come to reality, because as you play basketball or you play anything, Jonathan can contest to this. Music is not going to be there all the time, but he can keep singing music as he get older and older, and it probably won't be the same as when he was younger and selling a lot of more albums or CDs or whatever. But when I came to basketball is a little bit different than music, because my body's going to get old. I'm going to get older. It's going to be younger generations. And you have to know when your body says, hey, it's over.
Yeah.
It's over. You know, so I came to realize when it was just time for me realistic.
I was wondering if you was just going to keep slipping past that word. You said, really, is this? No. But
this
that's a GP
my,
word.
This is my word.
It's a dictionary word. Right? Yeah.
So yeah. When I came to that realistic, it was when I knew that I was going to be a backup player to someone else.
Yeah.
And these younger kids started to come out.
Sure.
And then I became a mentor.
Right.
When I became a mentor and these kids start seeing old head or old man and all that stuff, I knew that was over. And then I just had to flip my script.
Yeah, for me, you know, if the minute, the day you hear me sing Falling in Love with Jesus like this, falling in love. Quit. Tell me to quit. Just stop me in the church.
Well, hey, hold on.
When I do that, tell me to quit, please.
Oh, you know
I will.
What? I won't. No, we're not going to tell him to quit. We're just going to say, bring somebody else and you groom them. That's all we're going to say.
Go.
And then your daughter,
there
right there. And then you start, and then what would you say? How would you sing Falling in Love?
You know, you ever get to that church and they sing like that, and the bishop all gonna go, all right, brother, let the Lord work with you. That's no time to come on off. All right, brother, we gonna move on with the service. Yeah.
Well, move on with the service and read them Twitters, boy.
On the Twitter, at eBreak22, referring to the Eagles' new signing, my man said it's kind of like them they're kind of like the Miami Heat of the NFL.
What do you think? Philly.
What do you think?
They are loading up, but it's a little different. You only get two players on the Miami Heat. They're a team of 60 players. It's a little bit different.
But
we don't know what's going to happen.
They picked up some nice pieces, man.
They picked up some nice pieces, but they got to work together. You know what I'm saying? Right. I think the whole thing is Michael Vick.
Michael Vick got to get that started, and then their defense has to be okay. You know what I'm saying? So it's a little different.
And I like what they picked up as far as a backup quarterback, because I don't think Mike could play a whole season. Has he ever played a whole season? No.
He's always missed one or two games.
One or two games,
every year.
So. Well, Vince Young, I think they're going to play him together. Jess, I think they will play him together. I think they'll go to that college type of stuff when Vince Vic be in the back, and then they hike the ball to whoever, and then one of them start to run. I think they're going to get a little crafty like that.
And Vince is big. Vince is a big boy. Yeah. Another Twitter, at 01 Dirt Dog.
You can, Eagle you can read?
We're going to move on. we're going to move on past that. My man thinks that they will win the NFC and win the championship. What do you think?
I put a bet on that. I think their odds, ain't their odds number one right now, Jess, to win it?
Yeah, I mean, it's hard to bet against them right now, but it's still so early to tell. They'll be up there for sure.
I could see an Eagle-Jets Super Bowl.
What, Jonathan, what you think?
Eagle-Jets? Hey, you know, I'm going to call my son. I'm going to ask him what he thinks
about
this situation.
But I like how you looked up in there and you went, Eagle Jets.
Yeah, because I'm sitting with you guys. I'm like, hey.
Hockey team, right?
You know. But, yeah, I'll talk to my boy about that.
Okay. Thank you.
Super Bowl.
Cool. There you go.
Saints and Colts again. Watch.
Saints and Colts.
God.
You mean I'm going to get to the first?
God, keep writing on your pad. We're going to take a break. We're going to take a break, man. Oh, man, go to San Francisco 49ers. Hey,
like a college team right now.
Boom, 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 boom. Boom, 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 boom.
We'll be back with the Gary Payton Show. And we're back to the Gary Payton After the Game Show with Gary.
You see how that came in, Speedy? Shut up, Speedy. Don't say that. Hey, keep the beat going. Keep the beat going. Hey. I got Jonathan over there rocking, boy. I got to keep this going. Hey, boom. Yes. Boom. And he got his knee going. A boom. Hey. A boom. Yes, sir. A boom. Go pop. Cut it.
I'm going to just go on a limb and go, I don't think Jonathan Butler know anything about the police after me.
Listen.
I know about all music. No, the police.
First of all, why would you want to even say the police after you?
Because you ever get pulled over? If they ever ask you to get out your car, you'll never get back in. It's a wrap after that. Can you step out the car?
I ain't never had that problem.
Well, I want to give a shout out. My man, Louis Dix. Right here from the show is if you live in Los Angeles, he's at Mavericks Flats tonight, right off of Crenshaw Boulevard. Very funny comedy night there tonight. So definitely come on out. Support my man Louis Dix at Mavericks Flat. The address you can look up is right on Crenshaw Boulevard, right after Stocker Boulevard. So just go over there and check it out. We're going to head over there after this. But right now we got Jonathan Butler.
Yep. Check
on
this
the
out.
Dopest looking guitar I've ever seen.
We sorry today. We had a special guest on here, and we had to let him just take over everything. You know what I'm saying?
The
you
JP hear that, show. Right? The JP you hear show. That?
We didn't have a lot of callers, call-ins, but we good today. But he going to close the show out for us for the next couple of minutes.
Is it time
to
go?
You know what I'm saying? Jess will read the tour in D.C. Read that, Jess, and then we're going to go right to Jonathan Butler, man, and end this show.
Jonathan Butler, tour dates, if you guys are looking. August 5th, Newport Beach.
Yes.
August 10th, Detroit, Michigan.
I'm there.
August 13th, Richmond, Virginia.
I'm coming.
19th, Redwood City, California.
Cool.
August 21st, Temecula, California. September 3rd, San Diego, California.
I'm there.
And then they'll be in D.C. All in October, and then they end in Cape Town, South Africa, all throughout November. So be sure to check that out. Here in any of those areas.
Now get it going, Jonathan. Let them see what they gonna make, what they gonna get. This is what you gonna get.
Took a vow to be ever true. I live up to mine, baby. Did you? Somebody saw you with your own love, hand in hand. I don't understand. You said it and then long ago. You had me believing when you were deceiving me with lies. I wish I could have seen it in your eyes. Lies, but I never did. Say lies. I took so long to realize, but I was too caught up in your web. Like somebody called out the stranger time.
I heard another man's voice on the other side.
That was me.
You give me the same old story. It's just a friend, oh, oh. That's who it is alone, yeah. I hate to tell you my faith in you is shaken. Don't tell me that you love me when I know you cheated on me, baby, with lies, lies. I wish I could have seen it in your eyes, lies, but I never did.
But I never did.
Say lies, lies. It took so long to realize, lies, oh. Long. Say what? I say you cheated on me.
You cheated on me.
With a white lie.
A white lie.
With a wicked lie.
A wicked lie.
Say, oh, 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 no. You cheated on me.
You cheated on me.
With a white guy.
White guy.
Oh, babe.
Hey.
I'm out of here.
Out of here.
Out of
here.
Oh,
out of here.
Yeah.
Out of here with a white guy.
Hilarious.
Hey, there it is.
Great man. Show, man.
Great
man.
Show. Thank you. This is Gary Payton.
Cheated on me with a white guy.
After the game, we out of here, man. That's how we end this piece, man. Get it going. Hey, bam.
With a white guy. With a white guy.
Shit stink, pink gators.